When a thyroid nodule is first detected, it is understandable that most patients assume the worst, that cancer is present, though this typically is not true. However, a workup is performed in order to obtain a definitive diagnosis. The most informative way to evaluate a thyroid nodule is by ultrasound, even if a CT or MRI has already been performed. A large amount of information can be gained from an ultrasound, including size, blood flow, presence of calcium deposits, and whether an area is solid or liquid. A numeric risk score based on these characteristics can indicate whether a given nodule needs nothing else done, requires a repeat ultrasound for comparison in a year, or if the nodule requires a needle biopsy for further testing. In addition to the ultrasound, a simple blood test called thyroid stimulating hormone, or TSH, can be very helpful in understanding what is going on with a thyroid gland. If a person has one thyroid nodule and a low TSH, indicating hyperthyroidism, neither biopsy nor surgery is usually necessary, and treatment with medicine alone is all that is needed. If a decision is made that a thyroid nodule does need to be biopsied, this is accomplished by inserting a needle into the nodule under ultrasound guidance. Intentional back and forth motion of the needle is performed to collect enough thyroid cells to be analyzed in order to classify the nodule into one of six categories. Known as the Bethesda system, the categories include malignant, suspicious, benign, indeterminate, and non-diagnostic. A needle biopsy result is non-diagnostic about 5-10% of the time, and it should not be interpreted as either good news or bad news, but rather the absence of information. Non-diagnostic biopsies typically result from inadequate amount of thyroid cells obtained during the biopsy. Repeat biopsy may need to be performed. Nodules classified as benign have a 0-3% chance of being cancerous, whereas nodules classified as suspicious for malignancy have a 50-75% risk of being cancerous. There are two intermediate categories that together have a cancer risk between 10-40%. Needle biopsy specimens interpreted as being malignant are indeed proven to be cancerous 97-99% of the time. It is important to note that the Bethesda classification system does not definitively diagnose a nodule as cancerous or not. It only provides an estimate of cancer risk which the doctor and patient need to take into consideration when deciding whether to pursue thyroid surgery or not. For those nodules found to be indeterminate for cancer, genetic testing can be performed to more precisely determine actual risk. Keep in mind that even genetic testing cannot provide absolute certainty of whether a nodule is cancerous, but it can improve the odds of correctly identifying a nodule as either cancer or not cancer. For example, if a thyroid nodule is biopsied and the Bethesda classification system gives it a 10-40% chance of being cancer, additional genetic testing might change the likelihood of cancer lower, such as 5%, or higher, such as 70%. Once decision is made to proceed with thyroid surgery, usually only one lobe of the thyroid gland containing the suspicious nodule is removed. With removal, the pathologist can now definitively say whether cancer is present or not. If cancer is present, then the rest of the thyroid gland may need to be removed along with any suspicious lymph nodes.